real adorable.
Hey, Myrtle, how's about going up to Sheepshead Bay?
Now what you hate?
Why not?
Because you are a married man, and I simply do not associate with married men.
Since when?
Yesterday.
Fresh. Listen, gather around the stoop. I have a very interesting story to tell you. It's the story of my life. It's practically a saga. I was born a poor but honest, respectable girl at 437 and a half Nordstrom Avenue. Papa worked in a factory and he loathed it, he loathed it. So after my education, where do I end up? Naturally, it's in a factory. Desirous of a cigarette, I waltzed out under the fire escape and I leaned over the railing frontwards, and who should pass by but the new foreman. Oh, he was adorable. His name was Hugo, so I made some pretense of not caring for him and I hollered, "Hey there, you with the stars in your eyes." He acquiesced. He was absolutely adorable. And the following Saturday night, we went to Coney Island. The night was young, and so we went from place to place like crazy man.
Gee, it must have been grand and all.
And you got one me a cutie doll.
Did you go to the movie?
Yeah.
What'd you see?
Some Marilyn Monroe and Niagara Reed.
Marilyn Monroe? Holy gee!
She certainly doesn't appeal to me.
Did you throw the darts and balls and hoops?
If that's your life, we looped the loop. You could turn out a shirt and rang the bell.
Rang the bell?
Between you and the gatepost, Dan and I, we did everything money could buy. Oh, it was so perfectly marvelous. And then we went to his place. It was the first time ever took off my shoes in a gentleman's quarters. I shall skip the details and simply intimate we spent a very pleasant weekend. Next day, I couldn't wait to tell my girlfriend Cassandra about the perfectly romantic experience with George. Truly had just experienced. So we had a rendezvous on the fire escape. She was all ears, so I told her. And then she told me that Hugo was a married man, so I told her to mind your own business. The following Saturday afternoon, I was in Prospect Park, and there was Hugo playing with his three children. I made some pretense of not recognizing him, and I said, "Hey, damn, you have the stars in your eyes. Listen to me, Hugo. As far as I'm concerned, I want no part of you. You are a married man. Kindly stay out of my life forever."
Yeah!
So that's why I can't go with you. You're married.
Ah, Myrtle, forget it!
I don't want to forget it. I want to carry my torch.
Boy up!
Hey! Where did you say you were going?
Sheepshead Bay!
Sheepshead Bay, take me out to
Sheepshead Bay.
Sheepshead Bay, I love to travel out to Sheepshead Bay.